Just now we are getting into the AstroSat mission. Right now, just on the 16th of August, the satellite left Bangalore. It has reached Sriharikota. Now the launch vehicle is getting assembled, and we expect to launch this satellite, AstroSat, on the 28th of next month, that is in September. And this one has the scientific objectives of to understand high energy processes in binary systems containing neutron stars, black hole sources, estimate magnetic fields of neutron stars. And this will provide simultaneous multi-wavelength observations using single satellite. In fact, this data is also being looked up to by the international community. It has got UV optical, low and high energy X-rays, and then multi-wavelength observations. Then it has also got major astronomy institutions and some of the universities in India will be participating in this. And it has got a UV telescope, then the soft X-rays, then large area X-ray proportional counter, and also CZTI instrument. And this is the going to measure the photosphere of Sun, then chromosphere, then you also have different types of celestial objects. Then you have the launch itself we are planning in September, and its orbit is going to be 650 km near equatorial, and it will be a low inclination orbit, about 6 degree inclination, and mission life is expected to be about 5 years. And you can see the satellite getting integrated and going through the various test phases. And this is the ultraviolet telescope, UV telescope, which is based on a Rishi Creighton two-mirror system. It makes use of intensified CMOS detectors, and it operates in the 130 to 180 nanometer and 200 to 300 nanometer and also 320 to 550 nanometer wavelength regions. And here the lead is IUCA, then IAEA, and also collaboration with Canadian Space Agency. This is a picture of a large area xenon proportional proportional counter, and it works in the 3 to 80 keV range. And one of the things is it has got 5 times more effective area. You will see in a subsequent comparison, this happens to be one of the largest effective area instrument that is going to go off. The better than that will be going up only in the year 2021. This makes use of gas-filled proportional counters, and this is a very significant development which has happened at TIFR and Raman Research Institute. It has got about 8,000 square centimeter of effect, the aperture area, and energy range is 3 to 80 kV. Then soft X-ray telescope, this is again TIFR in collaboration with University of Leicester, UK. And it works in the 0.3 to 8 kV region. Then the cadmium zinc telluride imager. In fact, in this particular satellite, the total weight of all the payloads together is more than about 500 and odd kilograms, which is a very significant difference compared to many of our other satellites. Then you also have a scanning sky monitor, which will scan the sky and then detect transient events, and based on these transient events, planning of the mission can be done for observations in the other wavelength and telescope usage. This is the one which I was mentioning. If you compare the worldwide X-ray missions, you can see that the LAX PC, when it goes up, will be the largest efficient effective area instrument, and then better than that you are going to get only in the year 2024. Then all this shows where the instruments are located on the satellite. And this is another interesting thing, that AstroSat is going to be operated like an observatory in space. Data is open to both Indian and international proposers depending on the percentage of time allocation. There is going to be a performance verification phase, which will be first 6 months after launch, and then we will have a guaranteed time, 6 months period after the performance verification phase. then you have a regular observation phase, and then the targets of opportunity aimed at new transient sources, which cannot be predicted in advance, of course. Then 2% of the observing time is reserved for collaboration and for monitoring, maintaining the health of the instruments. Of course, challenges in realizing is, of course, it took quite a bit of time before the satellite itself and the total system was realized. But then it's a complex science mission with participation of a large number of research institutes. And this is the first mission to be operated in India as a space observatory. And it has got a 1.8 arc second resolution in the UV channel. Then it's an indigenous, this again, one of the very important developments, that indigenous thin foil gold coated aluminum X-ray optics for the S60. High pressure counters.